I am going to discuss on the topic polymorphism in Nidaria. What is polymorphism? Polymorphism is consist of the two words. One is poly and another is morph. Poly mean many and morph mean form. And polymorphism is the occurrence of several different types of individuals within a single species during its life cycle as members of a biological aggregation of a colony. Now the members perform different functions for the colony. There is a clear division of labor, thus the members differ in form and function in a colony that are said to be polymorphic, and the phenomena that is known as polymorphism. The polymorphism phenomena is widespread within the animal kingdom, particularly among the hydrozoan cnidarians, especially the members of order Siphonophora and Hydroidea. Among them, polymorphism phenomena is particularly well developed and famous for the members of order Siphonophora. The Siphonophorans largely exist as marine pelagic colonies displaying remarkable degrees of polymorphism. Now, these are the two forms. One is a polyform and another is a medusa form. So many differences in between the polyp and medusa. On the basis of habit, polyp is sessile and fixed and sometimes really free, whereas the medusa is free swimming. On the basis of shape and size, the polyp is hollow and conical sac-like structure, whereas the medusa circular or umbrella-like structure. It is a small, measuring about only few millimeter in length, whereas the medusa measures about 6 to 7 millimeter in diameter. It is very simple in structure, whereas the medusa is a complicated in structure. The polyp covered in protective cuff, separate covering that is called the hydrotheca, whereas the hydrotheca or any protective layer absent in the medusa. The mouth is circular. The mouth is situated at the tip of the manubrium, where the mouth, that mouth is almost rectangular, that's situated at the tip of the manubrium, and that's surrounded by the oral lobes. Velum is absent in case of the polyp, whereas the medusa, velum present and fully developed around the margin. The sense organ absent in polyps, whereas the marginal sense organ statocyst, that's present in medusa. The bases of the tentacles are not solenoid, whereas the medusa, the bases of the tentacles are the solenoid structure. The mesoglia is poorly developed in polyp, whereas the mesoglia is well developed in medusa. On the basis of reproduction, gonads are absent in polyps, whereas the gonads are present on the radial canal, especially the medusa. The polyp is a nutritive zooid, and that represents the asexual generation, whereas the medusa is a reproductive zooid, and that represents the sexual generation. Now, if we see what are the patterns of the polymorphisms and that are found among different members of the hydrozoa that show varying degree of polymorphism. So it may be dimorphic, maybe trimorphic, maybe polymorphic. Dimorphic is a very simple and common pattern of the polymorphism that is exhibited by the most hydrozoan colonies, as for example, Obelia, Tibularia. They have two types of zooids. What is zooids? Actually, the unit of the colony that is known as a zooids. That the zooids, the name, two types of zooids, so they are known as a dimorphic. One type of the zooid, that is a gastrozooids, that is a concerned with the feeding, and another type of the gonozooids, that is concerned with the asexual reproduction. Now, the trimorphic colony. Gastrozooids and another is a gonozooids, and when another additional zooids, dactyl zooids are added, then it is a trimorphic. Dactyl zooids are non-feeding defensive structure that consisting of the battery of the nematocyst, and that's found in Plumularia. And next, the last one, polymorphic, that having more than three types of zooid colony, such as the gastrozooid for feeding, dactylozooid for protection, tentacylozooids for sensory functions, skeletozooids, this is a spiny projection of the chitin, and the gonozooids for the reproduction. And that is found in the Hydactyna colony that consists of the five type of such zooids. Now, what are the basic forms associated with the polymorphism? I have already mentioned the unit of the colony are the zooid. Basically, the zooids are the two types. What are the types? Polyp and the medusa. And most of the polymorphic units are basically modification of either polyp or medusa. These two forms alternate with each other in the life history of a typical cnidaria. The polyp produces medusa asexually, and the medusa produces polyp sexually. Now, first of all, we shall discuss what are the modification of the basic polyp forms. You know that the polyps are the tubular structure, and that is a elongated cylindrical form. The free end, that is called the oral end, which bears the mouth and tentacles. The polyp represents the asexual stage. And three general modifications are done: gastrozoets, that is a also nutritive zoets, that is for food ingestion; dactylozoets, that is a protective zoets; and the gonozoets, that is a reproductive zoets. So that are the three types of basic forms. Actually, that are the modification of the polyp structure. So first one, the gastrozoets. It is also known as nutritive zoets. And gastrozoets are the nutritive polyps or siphons. They are tubular with a mouth. If you see here, that's a mouth. At least one tentacle that bearing nematocyst. A single tentacle sometimes bear fine lateral contractile branches, that is known as tentilla. Now the gastrozoets that catch the prey and digest it. The digested food is thrown into the sinusarcal canal. So a function of the gastrozoets is food ingestion. Now the next category, dactylozoets, it's coming from the Greek word dactylos, mean finger, and that are the protective in function, that helps in defense purpose for the colony and also for food collection. They are basically tubular, finger-like, but without any mouth, no mouth, but with a very long tentacle armed with batteries of the nematocyst. And this protective polyp, that is known as palpon or filler or tester. These are the dependent on the gastrozoets for food collection. Dactylozoets associated with the gonophores, then they are called the gonopalpons. And the function of the dactylozoets is a defensive purpose. And the last one, that's a gonozoets, these are the reproductive zoets. They have no mouth and produce sexual medusa by asexual reproduction. And gonozoets are also known as blastocystes. They are club-shaped structure. Gonozoets show branch-stalked, that is known as gonodendrons, and that bearing clusters of gonophores, and it is also known as gonopalpon. So now, what are the modifications of the basic medusoid form? Medusa are free swimming, that bell-shaped or umbrella-like structure. They represent the sexual phase, as sex cells are produced from gonads by meiotic division. Thus, medusa are basically concerned with reproduction. However, in a polymorphic colony, what types of medusoids, zoets are they encountered? Pneumatophore, nectocalysis, hydrophilia, and gonophores. That are the basic forms. So first one, pneumatophore, that is also known as float. That is a gas-filled bag-like structure that function as float. The pneumatophore is actually inverted medusoid structure and devoid of mesoclea. The ovals are two-layered and highly muscular. The epidermal lining becomes glandular to form a gas gland. The gas gland secretes gas into the air sac. Pneumatophore shows great variation in size and structure among siphonophorans. Pneumatophore is small in Halistema, whereas very large in Physalia. Pneumatophore is also absent in some cnidaria such as Mugi, and another is Typhoides. Now the next one, nectocalysis. It is a swimming bells, and that is also known as nectophores and nectozoets. The main purpose for the locomotion of the colony, they are without mouth, manubrium, tentacles, and sense organ. The mesoglea are thick and contain muscle fibers. The rhythmic contraction and relaxation of the nectocalysis bring about the colony for the movement, and that is responsible for the locomotion of the colony. Next, hydrophilia. It is also known as phylozoets. Actually, phylo means a leaf. And these are the leaf or helmet-shaped structure, thick, flattened, and gelatinous medusoid body that having a canal or cylindrons within. They are protective in nature and help to shield and form important juliets of the colony. And it is found in the Halystem especially. And these are also known as bracts. And it is also concerned with the protection of the colony also. Now, the gonophores or sporocysts, it is concerned with the reproductions that are the sexual medusa that occur singly or in clusters or polyploid gonozoids. Most of the colonies are hermaphrodites, that's bear a testes or ovaries, and they are degenerated medusa without mouth, tentacles, and sense organs. And another category, that is a orophore, the function is contradictory. Someone mentions swimming, and some scientists also mentions it's a function excretion. It is an oval shaped structure with a minute canal connect to the pneumatophore, with which it always remain associated, and it is found in the Staphylia. Now, so many important polymorphic colony found in order Siphonophora. Members of the order Siphonophora that are almost found in the tropical seas, they are known for their polymorphic complexity. The diversity of the form exhibited by members is so great that the most satisfactory presentation is a description of a few typical famous genera. We shall discuss on Halystema, Nectalia, Physalia, Diphys, and the last one is a Staphylia. So first one is a Halystema. That's it is a colonial forms and looks like a single individuals, and that occurs in Mediterranean and other sea of the world. It floats on the top of the seawater. The animal shows many kinds of juvets. The colony consists of a long cylindrical floating dam. Especially, it is a stem-like structure to which number of different structure attached. This is a stem-like structure, and these are arranged in thin cirques, and that is divisible into two parts. So that's part, that is the upper part. That upper part is known as a nectosome, and this is the lower part. That's a part is known as a siphonosome. The nectosome, that is the upper part of the cynocerc, and that consists of the pneumatophore, and that consists of the nectocalyces. So first one, pneumatophore, on the top of the colony, that's a bubble-like body that contains air, and that is responsible for floating of the colony. And it is a modified medusoid. It is filled with gas, and it helps to float the colony on the water. And then next one, that is a swimming whale, that is a nectocalyces. Below the float, a long stalk is present, that is called the cynocerc stalk. Just below the pneumatophore, 3 to 5 pairs of the swimming whales are present that are closely associated. Their muscular and their rhythmic contraction and relaxation at periodic intervals propel the entire colony through the water. Now, the lower part, that is a siphonosome, that is a cynocercal stalk, that below the swimming whale, that is a siphonosome. On the siphonosome, just below the last nectocalyces, it's consists of several kinds of juices that arrange in group at regular interval, just like nodes and internodes of a plant. That is called the Carmedia. And each Carmedium that includes bract, if you see here, that's a hydrophyllium, then gastrozoids, dactylozoids, and the gonozoids. So first one, the bract, that is a flat sill-shaped hydrophyllium that is particularly covers the entire group of the zooids of the Carmedium. Now the gastrozoids, it is a nutritive zooids, you know, that is a modified polyp. It has mouth at its apex and a long hollow tentacle. On this tentacle, many nematocysts are present, and they are helpful in the capturing the prey. The tentacles show bracts, that is called the tentilla, and then dactylozoids, it has no mouth, with and branched tentacles having strong nematocysts, and it is a protective zooids, and that is a defensive in function. And the last one, that's a gonozoids, it is a reproductive zooids, and that produces medusa. They take up the sexual reproduction. So you see here, that's a Halystema, that's containing nematophores, swimming whales, bract, gastrozoids, dactylozoids, gonozoids. So that is so the greatest polymorphic tendency among the siphonophorans. And others, allied forms, such you see here, that's a Nectalia. If you see, that's a pneumatophore, gas gland, swimming whale. So this is the upper part, that is a nectosome. And this is a lower part, that's a swimming whale. Similar kind of forms, just like the Halystema. Now the next category, that's a Faisal Aidas, so commonly known as the Portuguese man of the wire. And the best known of the polymorphic colony of the Siphonophora, that is a Physalia, and the colony floats mainly in the tropical seas. And in this form, the float is highly increased in size and keeps the colony at the surface. The float is pointed. If you see here, that's a float that's a pointed. And at the both ends, increased along its upper edge into a crest of the cell. If you see here, that's a crest of the cell. That's allowing the animal to move by the wind power. Below the pneumatophore, stalk is absent. All the juets are arranged below the float. That are the different types of the juets are found. So first one, if you see here, that's a pneumatophore, that is a big and that is a colorful, that filled with gas, and it contains gas gland, which secret gas, mostly carbon monoxide. With the help of the float, the colony floats on the water. And there are no swimming whales or nectocalyces, and the entire colony moves with the air direction that's caught at the cell. Now, the gastrojuets, you see here, that's a gastrojuets, that is a modified polyps. It has a mouth at its tips. It has a long tentacle at its base, and the tentacle bears nematocysts. They're helpful in capturing the prey. And next category, that's the dactylojuets. It is also modified polyps. The dactylojuets are large and modified into fishing tentacles, and such type of the tentacle form an effective fishing net for catching various small pelagic invertebrates and the vertebrates. It bears a number of nematocysts, and dactylojuets are basically a defensive in nature. Now the gonojuets, they produce medusa, which take up the sexual reproduction. So the male gonophores that are reduced in size, but remain attached with the colony. However, the female gonopores, after maturation, get detached and swimming freely. In Physalia, gonopetals are also well developed and protect the gonojuets and the gonophores. And there are many related forms of the Physalia in different parts of the world. That's a notable form, them in the rhizophysa. Then another category, diphyes. Diphyes is also colonial, marine and pelagic siphonophores. In this genus, the pneumatophore is absent. There is no pneumatophore you see here. And therefore, the upper end of the colony that consists of a pair of very large, similar conical swimming bell. That is a swimming bell. The remainder part of the colony that consists of widely separated groups of the juets on a long stem, and that is a magnified portions of one end. And each group consists of a gastrojuets with a single tentacle and a reproductive medusa or the gonophores, that is a large protective enveloping bract. The stem often breaks up at the internodes and they detached groups of juets and then they're swimming independently. A similar form that is also found in Mugei, that is also a siphonophore, a small hydrojuan jellyfish. Now Styphalia. The colony of the Styphalia is another good example of the polymorphism. In this genus, the float is particularly constructed as an ovoid form that is known as a orophore. And it is placed at the lower side of the pneumatophore, an arranged circle of the swimming whales or nectocalyces. And below the ring of the nectocalyces, different kinds of the modified juets are hanged. Some are polyps and others are also medusa. The polypoid structure includes several gastrojuets. One is much larger, that is a main gastrojuets, and the gastrojuets are provided with a single tentacles, and there are clusters of the gonophores that are produced that are responsible for the sex cells, and the floats in colony that moves rapidly on the surface by the collective pulsating movements of the several nectocalyces. An accidental encounter with the tentacles of the siphonophore, which may hang several meters below the float, that can be painful and even dangerous experience for a swimmer. We shall discuss what are the important polymorphic colony of the order Hydroidea. This is based on the Porpita. And another, Velella, that seems to be a highly organized, and there is a single central gastrojuets with a mouth around it. That's a concentric row of the gonojuets surrounded by a few rows of the dactylojuets. Central colony looks like a single individual animal. So now, orbital that is found in all seas. It is a pelagic floats on near the surface. It is regarded as an inverted polyp as its body is discoid and contains flattened disc-like structure, and that is also chitinous cells, and the cell contains many air-filling chamber that function as a float or pneumatophore. Each chamber that's opens to outside by a couple of the pores. At the center of the floats, on the ventral sides, there is a single large gastroduod that is a nutritive in purpose. It encloses stomach and bears mouth. And from the edge of the throat hang many dactyloduodes. If you see, these are the dactyloduodes. This contains nematocysts for defensive purpose. Many gonoduodes, that are the gonoduodes here. That's hang between the gastroduodes and dactyloduodes. The gonoduodes bears a terminal opening, and gonophores. Gonophores are produced asexual birds, and these are the medusa-like and contain bale, velum, radial canals, and a manubrium. Gonads develops in the gonophores. The gonophores are set free in the seawater where they discharge the gametes. Now, what are the origin and significance of the polymorphism? Many theory, polyorgan theory, polyperson theory, and the medusa theory. The polyorgan theory that is proposed by the Huxley and others, according to them, the individuals of the colony are the organs of a single medusoid individual, that is mouth, tentacles, manubrium of the duets that will multiply into different types of duets and migrate from their original position. Thus, a polymorphic individual is formed. According to this theory, the polymorphic individuals is a single organism. Whereas the polyperson theory that is proposed by the Vogt and Lukacs, etc. And according to this theory, the siphonophores are polymorphic colonies of modified polyps which can produce medusa. And the last one, medusa theory, that is proposed by the Huckel, Balfour, and others, that agreed the colonial nature of the siphonophore, but it was developed from a primitive duets, probably a medusa. Now, most of the zoologists believe that siphonophore colony has originally developed from a single medusa. The manubrium of such ancestral medusa was extended and produced lateral birds in the manner which can seen around some anthomedusa. According to this theory, the entire cynosaurus is an extended manubrium, and first or primary bract is the umbrella. However, frequently, a primary bract is not formed as in Halistema. That is reported Marshall and Williams, 1972. So, the polymorphism is associated with life history of a cylindrate animal. The asexually reproducing polyps and sexually reproducing medusa that will be combined in the form of clustered and polymorphic individual is developed. The polymorphism forms are something different from Nidarian metagenesis. The metagenesis is concerned with the life history of the reproduction. On contrary, the polymorphism exhibits an example of the division of labor with a colony. Different functions are assigned to various duets for the maintenance of the colony effectively. And among the siphonophorans, the polymorphism phenomena also helps the species to maintain higher biological order in relation to locomotion and food collection. Otherwise, hydrozoans are mostly sessile forms with a limited power of food, so that the most of the polymorphic colony are successful in their course of evolution. Polymorphism is not only the variability that the individuals of a species can enjoy the environment, but also a division of labor for effective social organization and utilization of natural resources. Thus, polymorphism gives each species a flexibility of adaptation in the environment. These are the reference books, textbooks of zoology invertebrates, Marshall and Williams, invertebrate zoology, Rupert and Barnes, biology of animals, volume 1, Bibi Ganguly, Ekishina, and Eshodikari, modern textbook of zoology invertebrates, R.L. Kotpal. And this is a website and maximum photographs I have captured and collected from the Google image. Thank you, everybody.